Assalamu alaikum and very good morning to all of you. My dear students, how are you? I hope all of you fine and God bless you. Okay, students, now I introduce myself. I am your math teacher of class 3 from Ismailia Youth Services School. Dear students, before starting the teaching, I will share some instruction to you. So please listen my instruction very carefully and follow them. The instructions are: be attentive and listen carefully. No disturbance during teaching. If you have any query, so you may ask after teaching. Listen complete teaching with full attention. Don't involve other activities during teaching. You have to sit along your required subject book, copy, rough copy and proper instructionary box. You can ask question by writing in the chat box. Take a screenshot of each slide. Okay, now students, I will going to start the topic. Today I will teach the topic number 1, chapter number 1, notation and numeration, which is given in your book, page number 1 to 13. The topic is, what is the topic, students? Notation and numeration. Okay, now the student, I will share the today's objective. The objective number 1, 3-digit numbers. The review of the 3-digit number, because this 3-digit number you will already understand in the class 2. So now 3-digit number, and number 2 is introducing 1000. Number 3, successor and predecessor. What are today's objective? Number 1, 3-digit number. Number 2, introducing 1000. Number 3, successor and predecessor. Okay. What is notation? Now, student, I will share the what is notation. Definition of notation is the new method of representing a number in digits or figures is called notation. What is notation? The method of representing a number in digits or figure is called notation. For example, 1, 4, 60, 31. Okay. Now, what is numeration? Numeration is known as the method of expressing a number in words. Numeration is known as the method of expressing a number in words. For example, 1 is written in words, O-N-E-1, and 2 is written in words, T-W-O, and other number is 41. 40, it is written in words, 41. Or words and or spelling, and 60. Okay, understand everyone? Now, students, I will share this slide. So it is the 3-digit number, and in this slide, so how many bundle of 100? This is the bundle of 100, and how many bundle of 100? This is one bundle of 100. And how many bundle of tens? This is 1, 2, 3. This is 3 bundle of tens. Okay, and how many ones or units? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. There are 8 ones or unit. So how many bundle of tens? How many bundle of tens? 100, 3 tens and 8 units or ones. So this number is called 100. 3 tens means 30 and 8 units means 8. So 138. Now the students, I will share the example number 1. What is the example? This is example number 1. Number one, how many bundle of 100? 1, 2, 3, 4. There are 4 bundle of 100. And how many tens? This is the bundle of tens. 1, 2, 3. There are 3 bundle of tens. We will write the 3 here. And how many ones or units? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. There are 6 ones or units. We can say this is 6 ones, 3 tens, 400. And complete number is called 436. The complete number is called 436. Now move to the second example. 1, 2, 3, 4. There are 3 bundle of 100. And how many tens? There are 1 and 2 bundle of tens. And there's no unit or no ones. So this is 300, 2 tens, and no unit, no ones. So this is called 0. Okay, nothing is 0. So yes, read this number with me. All students, read this number with me. What is the 100? 300. What is the tens? 2 tens. And what is unit? No unit, no ones here. So this is 0. So we read the complete number 320. 320. Understand everyone? Okay, move to the example number 3. Number 3 is 1, 2, 3. How many bundle of 100? There are 3 bundle of 100. And move to the tens. How many bundle of tens? There are 1 bundle of tens. We will write the 1. We will write here 100 on 100 position. We will write the 3. On tens position, we will write the 1. And how many ones or units? 1, 2, 3, 4. There are 4 ones or units here. We will write the 4 here. And read the complete number 300. 110 means 1 plus 4, 14. 314. Okay. Move to the example number 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 3 and number 4. There are 4 bundle of 100. And look at this example. There is no bundle of tens. There is no bundle of tens. No means 0. Is 0 tens. And how many units or ones? 1, 2, 3. There are 3 ones or units. So read with me this number with me. Or students, please read this number with me. 403. There is 400, no tens, or 3 is units. So the number is 403. Okay, understand everyone? Now student, I will share the exercise 1.1 which is given in your book. Exercise 1.1 which is given in your book. So open your book on exercise number 1.1. The question is, count the blocks and write the numbers in figure and words. Count the blocks and write the number in figures and words. So first of all, look at this box. Look at this box. Here are how many bundle of 100? 1 and 2. There are 2 bundle of 100. And how many bundle of tens? 1, 2, 3. There are 3 bundle of tens, 2 bundle of 100, 3 bundle of tens. So 200, 3 tens means 30, and there is no ones or no units. So no means 0. We will write the 0 here. So the number, complete number is called 230 in figures, and when we write in words, so 230. Read this number loudly. 230. So 200, we will write 200 here, and 30 and 30. Okay, now move to the box number 2. In box number 2, found the bundle of 100. There is only 100, bundle of 100. And how many bundle of 10s? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. There are 5 bundle of 10s. So 100, 5 tens means 50. And how many units are? 1, 2, 3, 4. There are 4 units. So the complete number is called 100. 5 tens means 50. And 4 units means 4. 54. The complete number is called the 154. And also we will write, when we write this number in words, so read the number loudly. First of all, read the number loudly, then you will write in spelling. So it is 100, you will write 100. 5 tens means 50, and 50 and 4 ones, 54. The complete number is 54. So 154 in figure, and in words 154. Understand everyone? Now move the block number 3. In block number 3, how many bundle of tens? 100, 1, 2, 3. There are 3 bundle of 100. How many tens? There is no tens, bundle of tens. There is no bundle of tens. And how many units? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. There are 5 units. No bundle of tens means 300, no bundle of tens means 0, and 5 units. So the complete number is called 305. And read aloud this number 300. So we will write in spelling 300. 0 tens means nothing, and only 5. It is only 5. 305. Understand anyone? Everyone understand? If you don't understand, so please ask question. Okay. Now the students, in the slides, I will share the writing 3-digit number in various forms. Writing 3-digit numbers in various form. The first form is called 267. This form is called standard form. What is this form? This form is called the standard form. 267 is standard form, and when you move this portion, so in 100 column, 10s column, 1s column. So in 1's column 7, in 10's column 6, and in 100 column 2. So we will read this number 200 plus 6 tens plus 7 ones, or we can say this unit is called units. This is also called, ones is also called the unit. So this form is called unit form. This form is called unit form. So because ke this house, this complete house known as unit house, okay, so this form is called the unit form. Now move to the here 267. 267 means 200, 6 tens, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 6 tens and 7 units, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 267, the name of the number is 267, or this form is called words form. Okay, we will write number word form. Now expanded form. This form is called expanded form. We will expand this number in digits. First digit is 2, so this is called 200. Plus second digit is 6, so we call is 6 tens. This is called 60 plus 7, 67. 200 plus 60 plus 7, the number is called 267. Or students, this form is called expanded form. Okay, now I will explain the experiment in next slide. So listen to me carefully, okay, and learn it. Like, what is expanded form? What is expanded form? In expanded form, we write the number by showing the value of each digit. In expanded form, students, what is expanded form? In expanded form, write the number by showing the value of each digit. So this number is, this is called standard form. This number is 7294. This form, and in, we write in expanded form. So we will write the value of each digit number. First we will write the value of 7. What is the value of 7? The value of 7 is 7000. The value of 7 is, yes, what is the value? The value of 7 is 7000. Okay, my dear students. And plus, what is the value of 2? The value of 2 is on 100 place. So it is called 200. Understand? Okay. Now, what is the value of 9? The value of 9 is on tens place. So we will write 9 tens means 90. So value of 9 digit is 90. And the value of 4 is 4 unit. Okay. So this form is called expanded form, and in this form we will write the number in the value of each digit. 7000, 7 place on 7000, 2 on 200, 9 90, and 4 is 4. Understand? Now I will share another example of expanded form. Or I will share expanded form of a 3-digit number. Expanded form of a 3-digit number. So, expanded form of some numbers. The number 1 is 455. Okay. So, we will write the value of each digit. 400 means... 400 means the value of 400, this is called 400. The value of 5 is 5. The value of this 5 is 5 tens means 50. And value of 5 is 5 on unit place. So 400 plus 50 plus 5, what number comes here? Now, student, what number comes here? 400 plus 50 plus 5, what number comes here? We will read this number 455. Okay. Now, the second number is 800. The second number is 800. 800 in on 108 on which place? Yes. 8 on which place? This is 100 place. 800 on 100 place. 8 is 100 place, and there is no tens, so 0 tens, and there is no unit, so 0 unit. 8 on 100 place, 0 tens and 0 unit. 800 plus 0 tens plus 0 unit, what number comes here? It's called 800. Okay. The number is 800. Now it's going to look at this expanded form. Look at this expanded form. This form is called expanded form, means 300 plus 80 plus 4. 300 plus 80 plus 4. This form is called expanded form, and this form is called standard form. This form is called standard form. 300 plus 80 plus 4. 384 and 300. This is the bundle of 100. This 300, the bundle of 100. 80 means 8 bundle of 10s. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay. This is 8 bundle of 10s and 4 units. 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 units. Okay. So this number is called 300 plus 8 tens plus 4 units. So in a standard form, 384. And when we write this number in words, so move to the word form. Read this number loudly and write this number in spelling form. So 300 means 300. 8 means 8 tens means 80 and 4 units. 384. 384. Okay. Okay, students, now understand everyone all 3-digit number in expanded form, standard form, and in word form. Now I will introduce 4-digit numbers means thousands. 4-digit number means thousands. So move to the 4-digit number. 1000. 1000 means 1000 is equal to 10 multiplied by 100. When we multiply 10 by 100, the answer will be the 1000. This is the bundle of 1000. 1000 means 1 multiplied by 100. Move to the 100 place. 100. 100 means 1 multiplied by 110. 1 multiplied by 110, 10 tens are 100. So this is the bundle of 100. 110 means 10 multiplied by 1. 110 means 10 multiplied by 1. When we multiply 10 into 1, 10 ones are 10. So this is a bundle of tens. And 1 is one only. This is the only unit. This is only unit. Okay. Now in this slide, 1000, 100, 110, and 1 unit. 1000, 100, 110, and 1 unit. Okay. Okay. Understand everyone? 1000, 100, 110, and 1 unit. Now move to the other slide of 4-digit numbers. This is the bundle of 1000. This is a bundle of 100. This is a bundle of 10. There are two tens, but two bundle of tens, 1 and 2. There are two bundle of tens, two tens, and how many units? Count with me. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. There are 8 ones. So the complete number is 1128. 1100, 2 tens means 20, and 8 ones 28. Now move to the 1200. 3 tens means 30 and 7 units. 1200, 3 tens and 1 unit. So the complete number is called 1237. There is 7 units, 3 tens, 200 and 1000. Understand everyone? Yes. Now the student, I will share the exercise number 1.3, which is given in your book. So open your book on page number 1.3, and the question is, count the blocks and write the number in figure and verse. Count the blocks and write the numbers in figure and verse. Okay. Now, in box number one, count the blocks. How many blocks of 1,000? There are 2 blocks of 1,000. How many blocks of 100? There are 2 blocks of 100. How many blocks of tens? There are 3 blocks of tens. And how many unit? The unit is 1. So we will write 2,000, 2,000, 200, 200, 3 tens, 3 tens, and 1 unit. So 1 unit. The complete number in figure is called 2,231. And when we write in verse, so you must read the number loudly and write the number in a spelling form. So 2,000 means 2,000, 200 means 200, and 30, 30, or this is 1, 31. So 2,231, 2,231. Okay, now move to the second box. Here is 1 block of 1,000, 3 block of 100, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 block of 10s and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. 9 is unit. Okay, so in the complete number in figure is called 1,306 tens and 9 units. So the complete number is 6 tens and 9 units means 69. 1,369. And read aloud this number and write the spelling of this number. So write this number in words. 1,369. Okay, understand? Write these two numbers in your copy. Hurry up, write these two numbers in your copy. Okay, now the student, I will share the successor or predecessor. The number that comes just after a given number is called the successor. The number that comes just after a given number is called a successor. Like successor of 1 is 2, after 1 is 2. So add one number in 1, so answer will be 2. The successor of 99 is 100. The successor of 1,234 is 135. So in successor, we will add the number 1 on only unit place. Add 1 on only unit place. So the when we add 91 on in 1, so the answer will be 2. 99, jab aap 99 mein 1 plus karenge to number is called the 100, aur 1,234 mein jab aap 1 plus karenge on unit place pe jab aap 1 plus karenge, what answer comes here? Yes, the answer is 5. So number is that number is called the successor of this number is called the 1,235 predecessor. What is predecessor? The number that come just before the given number is called the predecessor of that number. Like predecessor of 2 is 1. So in this way, we will subtract 1 from the number. The predecessor of 15 is 14. We will subtract 1 from the unit place. The answer will be 4. The number is called 14. The predecessor of 100 is 99. The one minus 1 is number is called the 99. So here is example. Write the success of each number. 299, add 1. So number is called 300. 699, add 1 on 9 unit place. Number is called 700. 8,909, add 1 on unit place. The answer will be 99,000. So 299, 300, 699, 700, 899. Write the number, 2 smaller digit number. Smaller 2 number is 10. The largest 2-digit number is 99. Smallest 3-digit number is 100. The largest 3-digit number is 99. The smallest 4-digit number is 1,000. And the largest 4-digit number is 9,999. Now, I will share the place where the chart of 4-digit numbers, ones, tens, hundred, thousand. The 4-digit number on in the, this is unit, the house of unit, and this is the house of thousand. Now write the number on ones place 9, tens place 8, 100 place 4, 1000 place 1. We can write the number is 1489. We can say 1489. Hence, in expanded form, 1000 plus 400 plus 3 plus 9. Now, student, I will share the instruction, copy instruction. Okay, you will start the copy first. Outer face, you fill the outer face sheet. Cover your copy with transparent plastic. Okay, write your name on this place. Write your class on this place. Write your roll number on this place. Subject on this place. Subject is maths. Your subject is maths. Or school name, Prince Ali Boys Primary School on this place. Understand everyone? Yes. Now when you fill the inner face sheet, this is inner face sheet name. First of all, you will write the name. This particular, you write this particular with black pointer, and this particular with the, you write all this particular with your pencil. Use pencil for work. Name, you will write your name, father's name, class 3, section. You write the section, roll number, subject teacher name, and class teacher name. Okay. Now, on second page, you will make the title page of first term. Make the duration of first term 2021 and 22. You will make the title page of first term. You will make the title page with your pencil, a blue color pencil. And then you will make the title page of chapter number 1. On third page, you will make the title page of chapter number 1, notation and numeration. Okay. Now the student, I will share the home task. Do exercise 1.1, page number 1 and 2 in your book. Okay. Do exercise number 1.2, page number 3 in your book. Do exercise 1.3, page number 6 and 7 in your book. Do all these work in book. Understand everyone? All these work in book. All of you understand? Okay. Allah Hafiz and have a nice day.